Sitting at just over 32 feet long, just a smidge over 6,600 pounds dry, this CrossRoads Zinger 280BH can sleep up to 9 and is packed full of features, storage, and amenities you're not going to find on a lot of entry-level RVs. Let's go check it out. Hey, what's up? It's Chris Young standing aside the 2021 CrossRoads Zinger Lite 280BH. Now, this 32 foot, you know, roughly 32 feet, 32 feet, 6 inches, 6,630 pounds dry. This lightweight beauty can sleep up to 9. It does depend on your configuration, but you do have the space, style, and storage to accommodate enough people. And that's why I like the CrossRoads Zingers. You get some of those amenities that most of the time mid-tier and high-end RVs have in a entry-level RV. Let's start with the bunks here in the rear corner on the campsite. You got double over double bunks. You got the little curtain right here giving you some privacy. Dual USB and 110. Very nice feature because a lot of times you'll get one or the other. So having that here on the top bunk is a nice feature. And these are the plush 3-inch thick fur covered mattresses. Comfortable, the kids will love it, and it is 300 pound capacity, so you could possibly get two adults up there if you needed to. You only got the 110 plugs on the bottom bunk, but you also have some additional storage space underneath right there. You got your privacy curtain and your solid mounted ladder. This was the only thing I really didn't like about the bunks. I think the ladders could be a little bit wider, especially if you need to accommodate bigger kids, because I was watching Bob try to climb up and get the curtain, and I purposely didn't help him because it was a struggle for him, mainly because I'm half evil, but because I also was like, I'm not gonna get up there. Look, if you get the camera behind me, I technically cover up the whole entire ladder. So just keep that in mind when you're picking out this 280BH. Solid door here leading me into the walk-in pantry. Good space in this one as well. Lots of shelf space. You even have the storage underneath. I think these are great for if you're going hunting or fishing and you need a spot for your rods or your cases. Sure, it's your pantry storage. It can be ward storage. You can put towels, clothes, whatever you want. It's your RV. You can do whatever you want to with it. That's what's great about it. Got your LED light up there as well. And if you notice, everything right here in front of the entry point, pantry, bunks, and access to the off-campsite corner bathroom, which does make this unit turtle-friendly. Got your Coleman Mach controls right here for your HVAC. Got that 15,000 BTU AC on this one, which is ducted. You also have the floor ducts on your furnace as well. I like the plastic bowl here. The countertop space that I have here, a nice addition for storage. Corner-mounted large single basin sink for my vanity. Mirrored medicine cabinets. I don't have much of a raised lip on the top, but I got it on the bottom, so that's nice. Just be careful to put anything up there, because once you do set up at the campsite, boop, stuff will fall out on you. GFCI outlet storage underneath. Good spot for the toilet paper. And the single surround herringbone pattern shower. Now, these are a little bit bigger than last year's, so you do have some good elbow room. And with the 81-inch high ceilings in here, even with the vent and the fan, I don't really need it. I'm pretty good if I need to wash my hair or anything like that. I got my shower curtain right here. I'm not cramped. Got the little lip on the tub surround down there. Well, shower surround. I like to call it the tub surround because even has a little bit of a lip. Hopefully the water won't flow over, but you still don't want to wash the dogs or the kids in there. More pantry space here. And with this interior, you'll notice they went light gray, kind of darkish gray wood. Like the accent and the combinations here, along with the brushed nickel fixtures, it really looks nice. Some good grab and go storage up there. Good spot for your backpacks, your Kabu bags. Here's my convenience center. Run my slide out, run my awning, check my water pump, my water heaters, my lights, my battery, my fresh, my gray, my black tanks, all of that right there. More storage here. We got the slip resistant, easy to clean linoleum flooring too. The upgraded linoleum on these. Really, it's like sweep easy, clean easy. And when it comes to RV camping versus tent camping, I mean, when you upgrade to your first entry-level RV, there's nothing quite like it. The setup is easier, you got more security, more peace of mind, and you get to go out and see America in your own home. That's the best part about it. Entertainment center here on the campsite, got the frosted glass on the storage component up top, and you notice this is also where my cable and my satellite connections are, plus my 110 outlet. TV backer right here on the decorative back, sound bar built in, which you can use USB and also Bluetooth. Another little component shelf, some more storage underneath. That's where you'd put, I mean, you can't really put big stuff in there, but you know, it's still, it's good space to put things like hideaway Girl Scout cookies that Robert tries to steal from me every time we go film an RV review. But I hide them in the good spots that he doesn't know about. Our super slide over here on the off-camp side houses our jackknife sofa and our U-shaped dinette. Right away, opening up the living area space, giving us plenty of room to move around. I do like the design of this. I like the set of shelves right here. I like having everything, you know, around in a good flow. You don't feel like it's disjointed when you walk around here. Solid wood balances over my large panoramic windows. Also have the wood inlay, decorative panel in the middle, dual USB charging right there, jackknife sofa with the fold down right here, with the removable armrest. I'm gonna show you why I like these here in just a second. But these new couches for 2021, they're not the leather. They're a fabric material that's like leather, soft, cooling. I mean, it's not sticky. When you're moving around, you're not going to stick to it. But plush, comfortable, and the gray is a little bit darker than what they've had in previous years. It looks good, but the darker style will also show wear and tear less, and it'll show stains less as well. But when you're ready to kick this out as a sleeper, got this little jackknife here. This is why I like these little pillows, because it has the arm thing underneath. And I sleep curled up, kind of like this. And I usually have my arm underneath me right here. And I gotta tell you, man, this is comfortable. Now, jackknife sofa, as we say, will sleep one person. Now, you can possibly fit two adults on here. It's just, you'd have to sleep spooning. Kids, you could probably get two kids on there. But having these versatile armrests, very nice little add to the jackknife sofa. Come around to the booth dinette. This will sit 4 to 6 people comfortably, but that's where you do the reconnection. That's where you make the memories. You can also reduce this down into a sleeper. You'll see how we have the table laid down. You notice the table, there's these little built-in supports underneath each bench. That's where the table goes to give you the support for the sleeping space. People have asked, you know, well, how does it turn into a sleeper? That's how. Then you just move the cushions around, turn it into a bed, put a sheet over it, and boom, you get yourself a nice little double bed right there. LED lights over top as well, if you want to do for reading or just for enjoying the meals, the board games, the card games, or just reconnecting with the loved ones. Because I mean, let's face it, at the end of the day, that's what it's about. Your RV gives you a chance to reconnect with the loved ones. Go see the places that you did not get a chance to see. Cook the meals in your kitchen. Look at this large campsite L-shaped kitchen that we have here. The pressed countertop, the rounded edges, the blue LED accent light underneath. Very nice flare, but also serves as a nightlight. You got the undermounted stainless steel sink with a 50-50 split, high-rise faucet, and a sprayer. A lot of entry-level campers don't have the sprayer nozzle. And believe it or not, it comes in really handy. I mean, it really does come in handy. You're not spraying stuff all over the countertop when you're doing cleaning. Got my little LED light there, GFCI outlet here, wood balance over my campsite window, flush-mounted 3-burner cooktop with the glass cover. And I'm a big fan of these grill-style grates. Easy to clean, but easier to move the pots and pans around as well. Another outlet there, flush-mounted microwave, and look at my storage behind these frosted glass doors that we have here. Pre-drilled and screwed construction, lightweight, good high clearance too with these 81-inch high ceilings. So having the higher ceilings means you have higher storage as well, so you can put more stuff in. Got the drawers over here. Solid wood construction on these as well. Got the ball bearing drives, you know, full extension on them. Tons of space, tons of room. Got another little storage spot down there. I was actually hoping there wouldn't be a shelf because I'd like to put a trash can right there. But I dig it too. That could be some pots and pans or some cleaning storage. Once again, your RV, you can do with it whatever you please. Another nice upgrade for 2021. How about a 10 cubic foot, 12 volt fridge that's also frost resistant. So you want to get that, you know, you'll see sometimes when they freeze over, you'll get that wet spot and just drips everywhere. Right there, nice little feature. Last but not least, on the inside is the master bedroom, separated by the pocket door right here. Solid wood. I like having that. Long nightstands on both sides here. Bobby, I'm going to scoot over so you can get in. You got 110 on both sides, dual USB on the camp side, mirrored ward storage on the side. Good space there. Plus, I'm pretty sure we have some storage underneath the queen size bed here. And a strut supported. Another nice little feature you'll see in entry level RVs. Would like to see a storage shelf as well above the bed, but I mean, with as much space that we have in here that we're using as storage, I'm okay with it. TV backer is here, as well as your cable and 110 connection. But for a family that's looking to upgrade that camping experience for the first time, if you're looking for your first family RV, or you need something to set up somewhere that you know a lot of friends and family are going to come visit you with on vacations, this is a great entry point to the RV lifestyle. 32 feet long, 6,600 pounds dry, the 280BH by the CrossRoads Zinger family. I like it. What do you say we go take a look at the outside? So here we are on the outside, the 2021 CrossRoads Zinger 280BH. You'll notice our aerodynamic profile up front, the diamond plated rock guard, twin 20 pound LP tanks, plus power tongue jack with LED light. Having an entry level RV that has powered tongue jacks plus powered stabilizer jacks, that's a very nice feature. Add that to an enclosed underbelly, you got yourself some upgrades that you don't see on a lot of RVs. Extra wide storage door here from a pass-through storage, which is finished off. Great space for anything you want to put out here. Fishing rods, rifles, hunting gear. I mean, beach towels, beach chairs, umbrellas. You got a wide enough door that you could put one of the chairs in there. That's a nice feature because sometimes they're just knocking around inside the RV. Sealed safety glass all the way around. Get my large awning with the LED light strip and my marine grade external speakers. Cable connection and power, so if I want to set up an outside TV, I absolutely can. Or if I just want to play my boombox, plug in my big giant 1900 pound boombox I've had since 84. Love that thing. Plays cassette tapes, not CDs. What do you do? Double axle on this one too. You got the Dexter Easy Lube axles right there on the 14 inch rims. You got the extra wide berth too, which is going to help with the suspension going down the road. You won't get a lot of that bumping and rocking. Solid steps leading into the main entry point, and you'll notice the top step with the grip tape is a little bit bigger than the others. That's for safety and security, but it's also pet friendly because you know you want to bring the furry friends along with you. They're part of the family too. And when you're ready to tie them up at the campground and keep them safe and secure, you even have the little doggy latch right there. With a bunkhouse, I just think the outside kitchen is essential. And this one is nice. You got the prep space right here. You got the Flame King two burner cooktop, one of them high output, the little sink prep area. Plus you got area up above right here to do some prep. And of course, when you're having your outdoor bourbon, you gotta have the fridge to keep it cold. Cause when you're gonna do your three finger pour, it's gotta fit in there. Plastic clips keeping me safe and secure. Boom, good space right there. 4x4 sewer hose storage, spare tire mounted on the back. Plus, we are set up for backup camera. You'll see my spot right there for that. Those arch ceilings with the 3-inch rubber nozzles keeping the rain and the snow off the top. My cable and satellite connection right there. Come around, huh? And you'll see we have our dumps. Our gray tank, our black tank, our sewer outlet connection. Now we have 51, 39, and 78 on this one. 51 gallon fresh, 39 gallon black, 78 gallon gray tank. So that's pretty good sizes if you want to go off grid. External shower with hot and cold right here. Black tank flush and city water connection. Another nice feature on entry level RVs you sometimes don't find. And my 30 amp plug, which pulls in right there. Our super slide housing, the jackknife sofa and the U-shaped dinette right here. The other side of my pass-through storage. But the most important part of any RV is going to be this info panel right here. As you can see, the unloaded weight on this one, 6,500 pounds. Gross vehicle weight, 9,400 pounds. If you fully load this thing, you know, get up to 9,400 pounds, you want to make sure that your vehicle is going to be able to tow it. But that's where you talk to your specialist at Camping World and at Gander and say, hey, here's what my vehicle can tow. Here's where I want to take it. Here's how many people I need to sleep. And that's really going to help us guide you down the path of finding the RV that's right for you. If you're a family that's looking for something 32 feet long, roughly 6,600 pounds dry, can sleep up to 9 with comfort, ease, and storage, I got to tell you, man, this CrossRoads Zinger 280BH is a great find, one you should put at the top of your list, especially if you're looking to upgrade the camping experience and get into your first family RV. But leave me some comments down below and let me know, what'd you like about this one? What'd you not like about it? Because we love hearing from you. I'm Chris Young for Camping World and Gander RV and Outdoors. Thank you for joining me on this beautiful day. I'm going to go get some sun on something other than my 789 head, and I will see y'all later.